The second inside corner, as you can see, I already spread the thin set here. I just want to talk about the thin set. What I'm using here, I'm using the Kera Play, okay, instead of water to put on my thin set. My thin set is from Epay, that's one also from Epay, and especially thin set for mosaic and glass, it's called Adiflex P10. So that is the one I'm using here, and you have to use, because I have glass here, you have to use this Ultraflex rich and polymer, and you have to use this Kera Play substance instead of water. That's a very important thing to understand. So what I have to do now, I have to flat it, okay? So before I'm going to flat it, it's nice usually just to wet it a little bit. The towel, and if I come from here, okay, so what I'm actually really doing here, I'm actually doing a bed mat of 1/8 of an inch of a thin set, and you have to flat the grove. That's one of the restrictions of the manufacturer for this kind of mosaic, and I believe it's because of the glass. Here again, you can see what I'm doing. I'm holding it like that with 30 degrees almost. Press it slightly. And perfect. Same thing I'm going to do here. Just remember to wet a little bit this flat size of the trowel. And now what I'm doing here, you can look here, I'm actually holding it almost 30 degrees and slightly push it in. See, okay. Here I have to have a little bit of thin set here in this area, which I'm going to add now. I'm using this just to add a little bit of thin set in this area. I'm going to flat it with a towel. It's more or less perfect now. So, if you see this kind of a blue tape here, if I put it in purpose, let me show you why. You can see how clean it is. So this is the handle piece. As you can see, what we have now is a clear bed mat with no remaining on the pencil. That's very important, because then thin set, when it's stuck to something, it's very difficult to remove it. And this is the last piece. And all what you see is nothing but a bed mat. Clear and simple. I'm putting the first piece here. This is the first piece I'm actually putting. And the second piece. Okay. And what I want to give him, I want to give him the elevation that I need for it. I'm using this piece. You see here, it's a roller, it's 1/16, the width of it, I just take advantage of it and put it here as a reference, like I did before. So I have to elevate this one also a little bit and let it go in. What I want to show you, you can see it's exactly going the same level of this. This is very important that it will continue like that. In addition to it, you can see the pattern is like continuing, because these two pieces, actually one piece that I cut to two and I put it here. And I'm going to attach it with the wood. Very important to see if it's leather. Excellent, perfect. So I continue spreading the mud here, as you can see. So don't worry to put too much tinset, because you're going to level it with the teeth, with the vinage. So if you look carefully, you can see that I first spread the tinset here with 30 degrees angle to fill up, which means to spread it almost evenly on this wall before I'm actually using the notch, the vinage here, to level it. That's very important. First you have to spread it on the wall, then you can use the vinage. So remember, this area is already level. So I'm actually going to use from here. So I'm actually making 45 degrees. Okay, continue from here. 45 degrees. Top, I can use the small vinage here, put it like that, and here. See how much, when I level it, look how much tinset I have. As you can see, I actually level it properly with this vinage, a quarter of an inch. So now I have to flat it, and to flat it I actually have this one clean here, you can see it, it's clean. I put it here, without 30 degrees even, and flat it like that, and I clean it again now. Remember, I'm just cleaning it every time I'm actually using it to flat it. Okay, so to flat the stuff, don't worry about this one, it's not a big deal. Now what I can do, I can actually go and just install the other pieces of mosaic. I put in the reference. 116 here. Now here is the second one. I start from the bottom always. So I'm going to actually attach and flat the mosaic to the wall using this 2x4. Thank you. the scribe notches, just to like show 90 degrees over here. 90 degrees over here. And here. Perfect. After I use the wood, I just slightly press with this knot. Remember, that's not going to replace the wood. Just want to see how much level, how much is flat. And how much level it is. You can see it's exactly here if you look. Want to show from close. If you can see how much level it is, it's actually perfect. That's very important for achieving this kind of accuracy. So this is the last segment of this board, and I already spread the thin set. Okay, now I'm doing the same thing. I'm using this vinach that I have to clean before I'm going to use it. Look how dirty it is. So remember periodically to wet the trowel and to clean it before you use it. Otherwise you're going to get a very bad result. Look how much excess was there. And the vinach. We level it properly without losing any piece of thinset here. So remember this area from here to here I already leveled before. So I left it like that. And what I want to do here is actually a 1/8 of an inch bed mark of thinset. What left now is to level it to actually flat the gloves here and to install the mosaic. Before I'm going to flat it, I just let you know that this area has to be clean before. Leave it wet and using the same technique. So here I have a little bit of tinsel that's missing, a little bit, just a hair a little bit, and then I'm going to flat it. Use that size. Okay, so that's it, we're done. Okay, so now I have to put the reference here and to remove this piece of so look how nice it looks, clean, no issue. Just now to put the mosaic on the bed material, very easy to do. So I just moved this piece, the reference. This is a yellow reference, which is a roller with 116, and I replace it with a spacer that I put here on the side. Why I did it? Because I really need to use it. Use this 116 reference here. So that's what I did, and let me show you. So I put here. If you look here, so just replace this and I just put the spacer until I don't have enough space here. So you can see this now, the yellow one, the yellow roller, or the yellow reference, I call it metal reference here, which is 116, is sitting here, and I'm going to put the mosaic on top of it. You know, if I press with my finger, I press it exactly on the center, usually. But before I'm going to use the wood, just to slowly, just to attach it firmly to the wall. This is the hollow piece seal. I always start from the bottom and then I'm going up. Now the only part that left is here. I'm going to cut the piece of it and just put it here. And that's it. I didn't forget this wood because this is very important. To just stick it firmly. Flat it. Remember, at least 80% of the mosaic on the back should be attached to the wall. Otherwise, it won't last for a long time, especially in the bathroom. See, the yellow also uses a reference until where I should really knock it to the wall, because that's already been done. Sometimes you need to put a spacer even between the space here. Because some of them sometimes is not exactly perfect. So you really want to keep the distance between the space between the mosaic firmly, properly. So just remember that nothing is perfect. But if you want to really make it almost perfect, you have to look very carefully. See where it's not level. The space is really crooked a little bit, so you just put a spacer there and you get it properly. The only part that left is now this part. I have to cut it and put it there. So this is the last piece of mosaic which I cut now. Okay, but I want to actually use it with these thresholds. I also put a little bit of tinsel on it just to make sure it's secure. So I'm putting a little bit of tinsel here. Just to make sure it's secure. Last piece is the most difficult piece, usually. Just to clean a little bit and that's it. Remember this brush? It's an excellent one to just clean if you have a pincet between the space. It will eventually remove them. Put in the water, just wet it a little bit, and it will remove the pincet here, but a little bit of it. Okay, so if you look at that here, you can see a space. I can put my finger here. That is intentionally done because I'm going to put here a tile. It will go until here. Should be like this. That's the reason for this space here. Okay? And the space is specially designed for it. The only thing left here is just to clean area here. Not much to clean, but it's important after you finish clean it quickly, because if these things are dry, it's very difficult to remove it after that. Another thing that we have to do is we have to remove this piece of metal here and put spacer, because you don't put metal within cell because it's stuck to it and then it's going to be impossible to remove it. That's it. It's done. So that's the way it looks from the shower where I am now. Okay, so if you're getting close to it, you can see that there is no any dirt or any tin set on top. Because remember, it's only 1/8 of an inch a bed mud. So it should not actually, here you can see a little bit of bed mud. And here it's because we didn't use the tape to protect from the tin set. And you can see how clean it is in pencil. So this is the way it's actually looking from here. So you can see it here from outside. The only thing left now is to put the pencil on top of the mosaic and to complete the work in a bathroom. This is another angle, the way it looks from the shower.